I'll be reviewing Rag & Bone Man's album, Human. Some people got the real problems. Some people out of love. Some people think I can solve them. Rory Graham, aka Rag & Bone Man, sure can sing. Denying such a fact would be like telling me the sky isn't blue or the world is flat. And while you might be able to squeeze in these tidbits as alternative facts, not even the Donald would disagree that Graham is probably Joe Cocker's closest successor. The singer has spent many years doing the rounds at open mic nights in Brighton in the UK, and despite his impressive vocals, he actually started out rapping with a strong drum and bass influence. After discovering that he did indeed have a very fine singing voice, Graham embarked on a slightly different musical journey. On this debut album, it sounds like he is still finding where he sits musically. When his first single, Human, was released, it gained attention for its unusual mix of blues and hip-hop elements and really launched his unmistakable growl upon the world. There was something refreshing about how he mixed this old-school sound with modern beats, and the album is strongest when he keeps experimenting with that. Tracks such as Innocent Man and Skin go some way towards maintaining his originality, but the more mainstream ballads such as Love You Any Less or Grace push him into rom-com soundtrack territory. But Graham redeems himself on the modern blues gospel sound of Ego, and is keen to leave the listener with his true soul on the powerful a cappella track Die Easy. There's a lot to digest on this record if you can overlook the more mainstream elements. And I'm hopeful that Graham's unconventional side will eventually win out over time. So Bernard, how human did that album make you feel?
I can't tell you exactly why, but I just get this false feeling about this album all the way through. There's just, he's got a voice and it just feels as if he's put on some of these elements. This, he's got a bit of a growl. Yeah, he's got the blues thing with the hip hop. But I'm not sure that is the real thing and not the mainstream ballads. It just seems as if this is a nice way to differentiate yourself from the ballad singing young men around. This could all be completely wrong, and he's actually genuinely this bluesy guy who in fact has been made, is softened for these other things, but I don't know, there's something about it which just rings false with me.
You agree?
So I do. Yeah. I found myself oscillating throughout this whole album, going, wow, what a voice, that's great, I could listen to this voice. And then particularly with that a cappella track which you mentioned, you think, right, now I've hit something. The rest of it though, it felt like, you know, to me, an artist or a great artist is often someone, and like, radio comes to them. They just, you know, they have got a sound and it's unique, but somehow it crosses them through. This album almost sounded to me like he's going to radio.
But that Human song was a massive radio hit.
Grand,
massive.
Great song.
And I think it's very unique and stands out as being very different. And
it was also
very
co-written
much
by the same guy that's written songs for Christina Aguilera and Jason Mraz and stuff. I couldn't find the details for any other songs on the album, but I'm guessing his people got the big co-writers in. Because apart from Human, it fairly quickly went into that, you know, cookie cutter anthemic soul territory that could have been, you know.
And even the a cappella thing, it's good. It's very good. But it's the other box. we've got the anthemic ballad, we've got the unique element to you, we've got the bluesy bit to you. And look, we'll put an a cappella thing in because that's always good. That always goes down really well with people because they go, oh wow, he's a really good singer and he does it unaccompanied and you can do it on a TV show. You know, it's all the things there that someone, including getting all the right songwriters in from the start, not saying, well, we'll see what your songwriting's like and then later on put you with some people. There's nothing wrong with any of those things on their own. And in essence, there's nothing wrong with this album, but I wish I could believe it.
I do think he is an authentic singer. I've seen him sort of sing live. He's done a lot of performing with like Jules Holland and people like that, where you can see that he's got something going on there. He's aware that he has an interesting voice. And I think he only discovered that late in life too, which means he's still trying to figure out, I think, what he is as a performer. And I think that he's been pushed into sort of, let's make you sort of a bit like Ed Sheeran, but, you know, slightly not.
Yeah. I was going to say just quickly, I like you, I don't doubt his emotion or his vocalizing and his vocal skills. I just think sometimes the music doesn't match the sincerity of his voice.
Well, I don't think that he's insincere. I really don't think he is. And because of that, I'm giving him 3.5 stars.
I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all, don't put the blame on me.